chills. My dreaded coat is chill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah. Pippers up the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way, way before the deal. Say this one for your photo real. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm ill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills.
Having you got it, go snatch the skirt the lot. Go ahead, jump and hop out it, hop out it.
Rep for your prom,
where your post, your pop, and your projects. Pain driven, engine drumming. Look how far we coming. Heartbeat on the streets, you can do it. Ain't real for the weekend, sweet. This sugar, one man on me, but get deep. Watch what you doing. I ain't damaged goods, damming out the clay. You wish you could. I do this for the family, I might just blow my wheel. I'm keeping it so for real. Who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving they soldier chills. Treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah. Pippers up the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way, right before the deal. Say this one for your photo real. Blessing after testing, I'ma show them skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm here.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here's the kicker, Zane Gonzalez, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from the Superdome.
Come on now, let's go! Here we go! To Pittsburgh!
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And got his man complete. And all the way down to the 35.
Here we go.
A big play there on the first play of the game. And even 40 yards. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. Jackson from the shotgun. Steps away to his left. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
The first carry for the legend. It's Bo Jackson. They'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A great play there. 35 yards as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point by Elam, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, here's Elam to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. First and 10. Here's Mahomes. And a big loss here as he's taken down. The sack there by J.J. Watt. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A gain of right around 35 yards on a play that started back inside their 10. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Mahomes gonna throw. Got a man open, it's Darren Waller. A gain there of 21 yards. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. On second and 12, Mahomes. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division every year is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far.
A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And the Steelers signal for another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. First down with Jackson. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down. Now they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. A Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Boy, some big runs here, Charles, already in this first quarter.
Yeah, if the lanes are there, go ahead and exploit them. But what I like the most, how decisive he is, putting his foot in the ground and going.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now it's Jackson, rolling to his right. That'll be caught by Schlesinger, the fullback. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. But he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down. First down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. And my goodness, they're now out of timeouts here in this first quarter. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best offense.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Jadeveon Clowney showing the explosiveness on the sack. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. To try again after the sack. Mahomes complete. It's Johnson. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. It's Mahomes. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off Byron Jones. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Darren Waller, the intended receiver. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Line of scrimmage, again, the 37 as they line up second and 10. This time, Jackson will throw it. He's going to wind up and air it out. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. picked off by the former USC man, Taylor Mays.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
They defer to Brown to start the drive. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And that'll be incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Back to the air on second down. It's Mahomes. And the catch made by Johnson. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Under 10. Check. Crunch.
Check 50.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up about 6 as he gets this down to the 41.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. He was trying to get it to the Hall of Famer Barry Sanders there. And that'll bring up second down. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10.
Coming after you.
Hey, 43,
43, 15.
Hey, turn it up.
That's the
left.
Let's
go, baby.
Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
43, 15.
Check 37.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Second down now. It's Sanders. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. So 3rd and inches, and this will be the 9th play of the drive.
Here we go again. Shift. Watch the shift. Check.
Here's Harris, and he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Punching it in from a yard away as they are now on the board here in the first half.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. A good gain there on first down. That run will get them 7 up to the 32-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3. Throw left side complete. It's Holt. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
They'll run on first down. It's Jackson, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now the Steelers use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number 1. They go play action now. Jackson. He'll let this go for the end zone. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. 45. From the gun, Jackson. He's going to sling this deep downfield. This is caught inside the 15. Now the Steelers going to use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on 1st and 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's 2nd down. 2nd and 5 now. Jackson. Jackson hit and he lost the football. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the 3rd quarter. Set and ready to go for the 2nd half. 1 touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. This one fielded at the 5. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But, you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, 3 things can happen, and 2 of them are bad. He would have kissed it on the ground.
A run with Sanders. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
43.
On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you should have had a few men in the box there.
A first down run, good for about 3. Second and 7 coming up. The all-pro in 2 positions. Khalil Mack there to make the stop. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. He finds his man, Johnson. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
That's a gain of 6. Brings up.
Well, I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on 3rd and 1. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And open, it's Moss, complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
First down. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Line right. There's a line right.
It's going to be a long day.
Yellow.
It's going to be a long day. Check, 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 check. Slam, slam. Check, 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 check.
They go back to the ground with Sanders. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
I think when people start talking about the greatest Ravens of all time, Ray Lewis's name comes up pretty fast, doesn't it? Tackles like that, just the tip of the iceberg when you start to talk about his talents.
He was their 2nd pick after the move to Baltimore. What was that, 96?
Yeah, 1996. Jonathan Ogden was the first.
And Ray Lewis also 2-time Super Bowl champion and the MVP of Super Bowl 35.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
8th play of the drive, 4th coming, and they need 8 yards on 3rd down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Holt. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 20-yard line.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Gavin Gallo has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
First down, it's Brown, and he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized.
On 2nd and 9, Mahomes. Now he's forced out left. And he's got it. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
To the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers have taken the lead.
Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
45. From the 39, Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a 3rd down.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
Jackson. They set up the screen to Bo. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
To throw is Jackson. That's caught at the 25. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 25-yard line. Flushed out right. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter, got to feel pretty good as a defense.
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It's going to be a gain of 6 on the keeper, but it leads to a 3rd down. Jackson flush to his right. It's complete. He's got Gronk. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They run with Jackson out of the gun. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. We've got a 1-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
45 to Mike.
He's back to throw, eluding the pressure right. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away, live to fight another down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
45 the mark.
Rebut.
Throwing now is Jackson. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers. In this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
Yellow, 42. Attack, attack.
Check nickel, nickel, nickel. Begin.
Our touch.
They'll run on first down. Sanders. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Going to throw it here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought? That had to be. Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked off that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
This will be taken very short. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Here we go.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They need to get this around the 40 to have a chance to win it in regulation. From the 40, it's a 57-yard field goal, so that gives you a gauge.
And all they're trying to do now is pick up yardage in good chunks and get out of bounds to stop the clock. If they end up running a play and get tackled in bounds, they're worried the clock may run out on them and finish the game.
And they'll have to be careful how they handle this. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Six-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. Third down here. Back to throw, Mahomes. That's complete to Calvin Johnson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first.
And the Steelers first down.
Now Mahomes. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. In for the sack, Myles Garrett. The sack cost him only a yard. It's second and 11. And the Steelers signal for another timeout as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. After the sack here, second and 11. Mahomes to throw. Got a man. It's Randy Moss. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
Attack, attack! 15.
They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. Johnson's got it complete. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. Mahomes. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. Johnson, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and ten. To throw, it's Mahomes. This will be caught by Randy Moss. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. And everything right now rests on the right foot of Zane Gonzalez. This from long, very long range. And off the crossbar, and it kicks back out. Needed maybe a foot or two, but it's no good as it stands. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after...
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets double, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team, and that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Throwing now is Mahomes. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Miles Garrett picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Gonna need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. Working from the gun, Mahomes. This is Johnson, he's got it. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down. And you definitely could make the case we might not even be in overtime had he not thrown three interceptions in regulation. But looking better here so far in OT.
Yeah, and when you think about what a coach is thinking at that point, because normally you've thrown three picks during the game, you might craft your play calling to be a little more careful. Not in this case. The green light still on for him.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first. They go with the ground game, pick up the first, now in plus territory.
And that changes the whole mentality of the play caller, doesn't it? Once they cross the 50, they feel like they're in the strike zone, all right? You don't have to be in the red zone to take those big shots downfield or go after the end zone. Right now, that might be available to them.
And now this first drive in OT continues. Here's Sanders. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
52, 43, 43. Where's 52? Watch 52. 52's the mic.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down, and he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. Another nice job there defensively. They've really stymied their passing attempts, and it continues in overtime.
And for them to do that, that means they've had to be cohesive on defense. Pressure in the quarterback's face, good coverage of not just the wide receivers, but the tight end, the running backs when they try and slip out, and making sure they're at the point of attack. When the ball's in the air, they get there and help force some of those incompletions.
And a catch made by Johnson. A gigantic call there in overtime, but it pays off with a first down. How about that, partner? Not only a fourth down conversion in a tie game, a fourth down conversion in overtime in a tie game.
And so many factors go into making that call, and a lot of it is a head coach feeling the rhythm and understanding his team. Sometimes you think, okay, we better get this done right now. We might not have enough left if we let this game extend. Let's go get it, end it, and get a victory.
On first down, it's Sanders. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
On second and 12, Mahomes. Got a man, it's Randy Moss complete. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down. Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're in OT, you've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. Well, they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmies and the Joes.
They'll run with the Hall of Famer, Sayers. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now that sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Sanders, that he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two, now third down.
A loss of two on the play. It's third down and 13.
So the OT clock hits zero, and we're still not done. We'll switch sides and need at least one more OT to decide it after this.
I
So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. So he hooked up with a veteran there, and in overtime, that's not a bad idea. Go with the age and the experience.
Yeah, because sometimes the young guys, they give you the fresh legs and give you all that bounce. But in this type of a situation, sometimes his legs slow down a little bit as the enormity of the moment overwhelms them. The veteran guys, they tend to come through.
They'll try and run it in with Brown. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the two, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create, and if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the two-yard line. Stopped him again. They did at the one-yard line. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. Another chance to maybe end it right here. This is third and goal. They'll try to run with Sanders. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal. A big one coming now for the kicker, Zane Gonzalez. This to at least get him a lead here in overtime. Gonzalez is good, and they take a 17-14 lead. They're able to put three on the board here on the opening drive of OT, and now up to their defense to try and see if they can hold this one.
I like how you framed it up, because obviously this game is not over, right? They go down and kick a field goal, then we head to sudden death. But if the defense can hold, take the ball away, turn it over on downs, this game's over.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. The field goal would push it to sudden death. We just saw the field goal on the other end, but I don't think they are thinking field goal, at least not to start this drive. They're not thinking field goal.
Not at all, because your point is well taken. Yeah, kick the field goal, you push it to sudden death, but you're also kicking off and giving the other team the ball with a chance to kick a field goal and beat you. Get the touchdown, finish the game off. That has to be the mindset.
First throw in overtime now for Jackson. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Overtime with 2 minutes to play. We are in sudden death, but still all tied up. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. This time Jackson will throw it, escaping the pressure right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Khalil Mack able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
That play was hard to see. One play goes wrong, and all of a sudden it's third and very long when they had been in second and inches.
Yeah, I know you like the idea of taking a shot on second and inches, but you can't take a sack for that big of a loss.
That's the one thing you cannot do. They gave it up, and now they're way behind the chains. Good luck with this next play call.
Third down, Jackson flushed out right. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left. Oh, it's intercepted. That'll seal it. Picked off around the 37. So we will see yet another drive in this overtime.
For whatever reason, Neither team able to finish this game off. I know that the first thought is, does anyone really want to win it? But I think that they both desperately want to win it, and sometimes you force things, and that leads to errors.
Well, it's out there for the taking. We'll see who can do it. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. This has been Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Join the discussion on Twitter at @EASports_MUT. Till next time, we say so long from the Bayou.